let's get started. Let's start by using a 3.5 millimeter hook to do our gingerbread man. Begin with a slip knot. Chain 15. We will start in the second chain from the hook, doing a single crochet. We will then single crochet in each chain across for 14 single crochets. At the end, we will chain one and turn. For our second row, we're going to do 14 single crochets across, starting in the first single crochet, going all the way across, 14 single crochets, chain one and turn. For row three, we will do 14 single crochets and just stop at the end. From here, you will turn your work. Now we will start the body of the gingerbread man. Starting in the very first single crochet, we're going to do 5 slip stitches across. Chain one, and we will do a single crochet in the same space. We will continue with 6 single crochets across and chain one. For row 5, we are going to do 6 single crochets across, chain 1, and turn. We will now start an increase for the next row. We will start this increase by doing 2 single crochets in the first stitch. Then we'll continue with 1 single crochet in the next 4 stitches. To end the row, we will put 2 single crochets in the last stitch. You will have 8 single crochets total in this row. Chain one, then turn. For the next 3 rows, we will do 8 single crochets, chain one and turn. You will now have completed rows 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we will start the first leg of our gingerbread man. Starting with 4 single crochets, then we will chain 1 and turn. Repeat this for row 2 until you have 6 rows total of the 4 single crochet. To round out the bottom of the leg, we will skip the first single crochet, going into the next one, doing 3 single crochets across. We can now slip stitch along the inside of the leg to start the second leg. Do 6 slip stitches. Now do 4 single crochets with the chain 1 and turn 6 times to create the second leg. At the end, you will again skip the first single crochet, doing 3 single crochets. You are now finished the body. You can cut the yarn and tie off. Let's get started and do the head of our gingerbread man next. Starting in the 6th stitch from the end, counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we will insert our hook and pull up the yarn. We will now chain 1. Starting in that first chain stitch, we will do a single crochet, doing 4 single crochets across, chain 1, then turn. We can now increase to get the shape of our head by doing 2 single crochets in the first stitch, 1 single crochet in each of the next 2 stitches, and then 2 single crochet in the last stitch, chain 1 and turn. We will do another increase in the next row by starting with 2 single crochets in the first stitch. We will then do a single crochet in the next 4 stitches, finishing with 2 single crochet in the last stitch. Chain 1 and turn. Our next row will just be 8 single crochets across, chain 1 and turn. We will now begin a decrease. The first one will be 2 single crochet together, and then 4 single crochet, and on the last stitch, we're going to do 2 single crochet together. To do the 2 single crochet together, you're going to insert your hook, draw up the yarn, insert the hook into the second, draw up the yarn, yarn over and pull through both. You should have 6 single crochet total, chain 1 and turn. We will continue our next row with another decrease, doing 2 single crochet together, and then 2 single crochet in each of the next 2 stitches, and the last 2 will be 2 single crochet together, chain 1 and turn. On our last row, we will skip the first stitch and then do 3 single crochets. We can now start crocheting single crochets around the entire gingerbread man. We'll start with the chain 1 and do single crochets around the whole gingerbread man. Tie in your ends or crochet your ends in as you go. Once you've gotten around the whole gingerbread man, slip stitch to join at the end. Cut your yarn with a long tail, approximately 80 centimeters or 30 inches. We need that yarn so we can attach the gingerbread man to the square. Using our brown yarn, cut approximately 80 centimeters or 30 inches of yarn. We will now do the details of our buttons. Follow along with me to see how the buttons are made. Continue with the same yarn to do the eyes. A simple cross for each eye. You can now turn your gingerbread man over and weave your yarn. I like to weave it back to the start and tie a knot. You do not have to weave your ends in completely. You can leave a short end because it will be tucked underneath when you attach it to the square. We will now make the mouth of the gingerbread man. Using white yarn, cut about 30 centimeters or 12 inches. You can make the mouth with a simple in and out stitch. Just starting from the back, go in and out until you have the shape of the desired mouth. Turn over and tie your ends. To make the tie, cut a small piece of red yarn. Insert from the front to the back and back up to the front again. Make a knot and then tie a bow. Make sure when you've completed tying your bow that you do a double knot on the bow to secure it into place. Clip the bottom of the bow to make it even, and you have finished your gingerbread man. The approximate dimensions of your square will be about 16 by 18 centimeters, or 6 by 7 inches. Using your 5 millimeter crochet hook and your medium weight white yarn, start with a slip knot. You can then chain 21. Starting in the second chain from your hook, do a half double crochet. Continue with half double crochets down the entire row for 20 half double crochets. When you reach the end, you can chain two and turn your work. For the second row, do 20 half double crochets starting in the first stitch, completing 20 half double crochets across. Repeat this until you have 17 rows in total. We will now do a border of double crochets. Starting with a chain 3, which counts as our first double crochet, we're going to go 2 more double crochets in the same stitch, having 3 double crochets in our corner. Crochet down the length of the square for 16 double crochets, putting 1 double crochet in each row. When you have reached the corner, you can do 3 double crochets in the corner. Continue on the width of the square, doing 18 double crochets, 1 in each stitch, and then 3 double crochets in the corner to finish the row. When you turn your work, you will do 16 double crochets down the length, with 3 double crochet in the corner, and then 18 double crochet along the bottom. Once you have reached the beginning, you can slip stitch into the top of the chain 3 space to join. Tie off your end. Now we get to attach the gingerbread man to the square. Start by pinning the gingerbread man into place. To create the invisible stitch, we just want to take the needle and pick up the top piece of yarn. Be sure not to go through. Then we're going to go through a complete stitch from the back. From the front, we'll go into the next stitch, going through both loops, and then repeating the process. Again, we'll pick up one loop in the front, coming up through the next stitch, and then going back down into the next one. Repeat this around the entire gingerbread man. Continue around the gingerbread man, shaping him as you go. Once again, make sure you just take the top loop of a stitch so nothing shows through the back. Continue around pulling and shaping the gingerbread man as you go. To finish off, weave your yarn into the back of the gingerbread man. Using the 5mm hook, start in the middle corner stitch. Pull up your yarn and chain two. We are going to do half double crochets for the first row around. The first chain two will count as your first half double crochet. Do two half double crochets into the same stitch. You will now increase this row to 24 stitches. Going along, you will do three half double crochets, two half double crochets in the next stitch, then one half double crochet, two half double crochets in the next stitch, one half double crochet, two half double crochets in the next stitch. We will then continue this pattern with one half double crochet in the first, two half double crochet in the next, one half double crochet, two half double crochet in the next, one half double crochet, two half double crochet in the next. We will finish the row with four half double crochets to have 24 stitches total. We will then do three half double crochets into the corner. Turning your work, we're going to do 20 half double crochet across, one in each stitch. Three half double crochet in the corner, and then going down the side, we will increase again to 24 stitches, starting with three half double crochet, one in each stitch. Then we will do two half double crochet in the next stitch. Then one half double crochet, two half double crochet in the next stitch. Continue again with one half double crochet, and then two half double crochet, four more times. We will then have 4 half double crochets in the last 4 stitches, and then 3 half double crochet in the corner. Finish your last side with 20 half double crochets across the width. Slip stitch into the top chain 2 of your first chain 2. We will then chain 3. This will count as your first double crochet. We will then do 3 double crochet in the corner. We will do 26 double crochets in the length and 22 double crochets in the width, with 3 double crochet in each corner. Once you have reached the end, you can insert into the top of your chain 3, slip stitch to join, and then you can tie off. Weave in your end to join at the start and tie a knot and tuck under. Putting the right sides together, starting in the center of each outside of the border. Insert your needle going through both stitches. Continue around, making sure you get through both stitches until you have reached the end. Now join in your next two squares. Putting your right sides together, lining up the center stitch, and continuing to the end. Continue with the next set of squares until you reach the end. Now start darning the vertical sides together, starting at either end. Make sure when you get to your cross section that you do a lot of stitches in there, maybe add an extra one just to make it more secure. Tie in all the ends. To complete your project, crochet around the border. First row with half double crochets, second row with double crochets. You have now finished your blanket.